If you step off the elevator in the lower level of the library, you look into the Central Information Center onto the Video Information System switch. The objective of the Video Information System is to assist faculty in providing quality instruction by improving their access to and control of a variety of instructional materials. The Video Information System may be viewed as a general purpose presentation system, which allows faculty to have improved access to and easy control over instructional materials in a variety of formats. Traditionally, audiovisual equipment and instructional materials have been delivered and set up by part-time or work-study students throughout the campus in all kinds of weather. No matter how hard you try, anything can and often does go wrong. Faculty are often surprised and intimidated by equipment which they do not understand and by the loss of control in their work as they try to accommodate the operator or the system. They also are often limited in what they can easily get. While the new Ball State system is not the perfect answer, it does go a long way towards assuring faculty control over their own destiny in the classroom. When using the Video Information System, faculty pre-schedule materials, 16mm films, videotapes, laser discs, tape slides, film strips, by simply phoning in their request and informing us of what materials they wish to use and when and where they wish to use them. This information is logged in on the VIS host computer, and at the desired time, the computer electronically switches or connects the playback equipment to the classroom. Nothing but the information is moved to the classroom. At the desired time, the faculty member opens the VIS panel and touches a few buttons on the wall panel or infrared controller. The instructional materials are electronically routed to the classroom, where the faculty member has full control at the panel or by using the remote anywhere in the room. It starts when you want and performs all functions as if the equipment was in the room. If it fails, you pick up the phone and get immediate help or a new source machine. This eliminates the need to deliver and set up instructional equipment and materials. It also standardizes and greatly simplifies faculty use of a variety of instructional formats. The VIS control panel consists of a touch panel, an infrared controller, a phone, and local input connectors. The panel is very easy to use and is labeled with self-descriptive terms. If we wish to change this, we simply print a new cover and reprogram the functions. While designing the Video Information System, we attempted to provide for a wide variety of instructional formats, including Super VHS, video players which provide a very high quality picture, about 400 lines of horizontal resolution, as compared to about 240 for a broadcast or cable TV signal, or 230 for regular VHS. VHS machines with four heads to allow a clear and steady still frame. 3/4-inch U-matic machines to play our older tapes and those coming in this format. Laser disc players for interactive and linear discs. Panasonic 8-inch disc machines for recording and playing back faculty video databases. 2-inch video floppy disk for recording and playback of still video and computer images. Closed captioned and multi-standard VHS tapes may also be played. In addition to the above formats, 16mm films, 35mm slides and film strips, audio cassettes, and audio compact discs may also be played. The key to the success of this new system is in its simplicity and how easily these differing formats are controlled. After unlocking the VIS panel, the green program ready light informs the faculty member that the program is ready to use. By pressing the power button, the monitor or video projector and audio amplifier are turned on, and the audio level is easily controlled at the panel. By pressing the respective labeled buttons, faculty may control the usual functions of play, pause still, forward and reverse scanning, and stop. If playing an interactive laser disc, the faculty may search to a specific frame by pressing Shift Enter Frame Number, entering the frame number, and then pressing the Search to Frame Number button. The monitor will then display that frame. Most formats allow the user to advance and reverse images frame by frame by pressing the Step Forward and Step Reverse buttons. The user may select from two formats at the same time. For example, video floppy and video tape by pressing the Source 1 or 2 buttons. If the user schedules more than two formats, access to the third format is gained by pressing the Scheduled Program Select button. Pressing the Menu button displays a menu from which you may select other items. Someone always wants to use something locally, and the Local Input button allows the user to connect other video, voice, and data equipment. The Phone Message Waiting button allows VIS personnel to activate the panel's phone message waiting light and alert the faculty to call VIS for a message. For example, a graphics workstation allows us to overlay computer-generated data or a video signal and store the combined image on a video floppy disk. The disk may then be used as a source in VIS. By using the Video Information System, Ball State faculty have improved access to and better control over the use of quality instructional materials in the teaching environment. We think the pioneering represented in the new system demonstrates why Ball State is the teaching environment model of the campus of the future.